Today, we will show you how the MCF8316A field-oriented control motor driver solves the top 5 generic pump challenges using 5 key device features, such as auto-tune torque loop, auto-tune speed loop, initial position detection, automatic deadtime compensation, and easy-to-use GUI. The liquid cooling system absorbs the heat away from the component, then dissipates the heat through a radiator using a pump motor. It is commonly used in enterprise servers and personal computers to cool down CPUs or GPUs, or in the automotive electric vehicles to cool down batteries. In this video, we will be demonstrating a liquid cooling system inside a personal computer using our MCF8316A to drive the pump motor. The first challenge of a pump is addressing the dynamic load changes. To solve this, we need to control the torque loop. The MCF8316A auto-tunes proportional and integral PI controller gain values of torque loop to regulate the torque. This reduces manual tuning and makes it more adaptive. In order to keep a constant flow rate, the motor speed has to be maintained constant. The MCF8316A auto-tunes proportional and integral PI controller gain values of a speed loop to regulate the speed. The third challenge we encounter with pumps is the load during a startup. There is high torque that needs to be overcome to start spinning the motor. Now I'm going to start the motor with IPD, initial position detection. In the motor waveform, you can see the IPD. We can see the IPD pulses are pumping into the motor. The position is detected by measuring the width between the pulses. By knowing the position of the motor, and thanks to the feature of configurable open loop current, the highest torque can be applied at a startup. Another challenge is the acoustic noise the pumps generate. This can be phased out by inserting dead time. This phase, current waveform is slightly distorted and might be bad for the motor and acoustically. Now, when I enable the dead time compensation, you can instantly see the waveform shape improve. This is not only good for your motor, but also good for your ears. Finally, FOC is a complex algorithm to implement and enable the pump to work in the desirable way. The MCF8316A is equipped with a control IC and all the features of FOC in one single chip that can be tuned using a graphical user interface. Thanks to this GUI, we can configure the startup, open loop, closed loop, gate driver, and controller fault settings of the motor. For this liquid cooling, I will configure the motor startup settings. I chose IPD. I'm also configuring the open loop current limit, closed loop for torque PI loop, and the maximum speed. The CPU is now under idle load and the liquid cooling pump is running at regular speed. We can see here the current idling temperature. Now we put the CPU under maximum load and the temperature increases sharply. As soon as I turn the water pump off by setting the speed command to 0% using the GUI, the temperature will continue to increase. Before it overheats and kills our CPU, let me turn the pump back on by setting the speed command to 50%. Now we can see the temperature quickly dropping back down. This GUI allows us to easily configure the complex FOC features in less than 10 minutes. And there it is. That is how the MCF8316A is used to solve liquid cooling challenges. Visit ti.com/MCF8316A to learn more. Thanks for watching.